A man named Keeley, back in Pennsylvania, built a free energy motor and demonstrated it to the highest scientific minds in this country. Keeley was later died in an insane asylum. His motor disappeared. Nobody has ever been able to find out what happened to it. We had a man in 1929 on the Cleveland airport that had a section of one hangar rented there, and it was canvassed off so you couldn't see what was there. For over a year, that man worked behind the canvas, and as far as anybody on the airport went, we all figured he was a little off the beam because he never did anything only say good morning or good night or how are you. The man's name was Henderson. One morning when I came to my job there at the Cleveland airport, I saw a Waco 10 airplane setting out on the line. The only difference in it and the other Waco 10s was the cowling was changed. This man Henderson came out and got in this airplane and flew it around the field. We didn't hear a sound from an engine. Everybody on the field rushed up to the ship after it landed. And he climbed out and permitted us to open the cowling and look him into the cockpit, into any part of the airplane. There were no batteries in the airplane. There were no gas tanks in the airplane. There were two devices under the cowling that looked like our electric motors, one of them end-to-end and connected by a shaft. I saw that myself. I saw it fly. The next day when I came to work, Henderson, the canvas, the airplane, and the whole works was gone. We never saw him again. We don't know where it went. Another man named Hendershow developed a motor. There have been half a dozen of these free energy devices developed to produce power. They work on the same principle as planet works on. In fact, these spaceships, the disks, are copied after planets. They use exactly the same principle in space relative to their travel that the planets use. We're sitting here right now on a spaceship that we call the Earth. It's traveling 1,000 miles an hour on its axis and 1,800 miles an hour in its orbit. And we are following the sun through space at over 12 miles a second. And yet we register no sign of movement. And those three movements alone, not counting the motion in the galaxy. We are wobbling on our north pole, which we can't feel. These motions are not felt because we are subject to the gravity of this body we're riding on. These people in copying the principle of planets and applying it to ships